Hi guys, and welcome to Ocean Afaro in Punta Cana, Dominican Republic. We had a 5-star. This is El Faro, which means the lighthouse, and it also has the adult only, which is called El Beso, which means the kiss. We arrived late at night. It's a bus that came directly here. Took us about 35 minutes, no traffic back then, maybe 40 during the day. Regular check-ins over here. And privileges over here. It's supposed to be air conditioned in here, but it's not hot, not cold. The smoking area out there. It's also where they have the silent disco, where they have to all wear the headsets. Coffee maker. Today is January 1st. It's about 10:30 in the morning. I was at the New Year's party last night. We're just taking the stage down now. There's a internet place where you can check your emails and stuff. This is your piano bar. Opens about 5 or 6. It's adult only, but believe it or not, there's kids in there. They don't seem to enforce that. It's a little frustrating. Right now it seems like it's about 25. It's supposed to get up to 30 today. A little outdoor eating area here too. Not eating, basically this is just for drinks. These are all the eating places here, the a la carte, starting with the Japanese, which we are going to tonight. Basically we had the privilege of since we got privileged, we have our butler book all our dinner reservations. Route 66, it's like an American style burgers and hamburgers and stuff like that, hot dogs. That's the place you go. It's open until 6 in the morning for your, if you still need something you have. That's the only place that stays open all night. This is your convenience store. Has everything in the roof in there. Pretty pricey though. One of my friends wanted to get a bag of Lay's potato chips. $15 US. Yeah, he didn't buy it. On the bus ride in, the bus driver does have beer on cold, beer on ice. It's not cheap either. I thought it was, last time I was in Punta Cana was 5 years ago. And price of beer has jumped. He made a big tip. He charged me $10 for 2 beer. So here's your gym over here and your spa beside it. Over here is like gym. That's the Italian, the steakhouse. We have that booked as well. I haven't been in there yet. Still playing this Christmas music. Gets a little annoying. I'd like to hear at least some Spanish music, which they do play around the pool. You're here, popular spot, always lined up in there, Mike's coffee shop. Get cappuccinos and everything, and they have little pastries. I will go in, looks pretty busy right now. And the other two a la cartes, the Mexican, which we went to, great margarita, and the French Blue Moon. Very strict on the dress code for that one. And over here, it doesn't say it, but that is the casino there. It is open, I think it opens about 5 or 6. and it's very limited in there. It had maybe three tables for cards and literally about four slot machines. That's it, four. I tried, put $4 in, that was it. This is your, what they call the main plaza. You see straight ahead is where they had the show last night. Fireworks afterwards. We had a bit of a surprise as 10 minutes before midnight, even though the forecast said 0% of rain, it just a monsoon, the skies opened. I videotaped it, I don't know if I'm gonna put it down here or not, but it's pretty interesting. Everybody went scattering, except a few couples stayed on the dance, some diehards stayed on the dance floor. There's your bowling alley. That opens also at five or six. And they got six lanes in there. Said it's still early. Here's your schedule of stuff that goes on today. Today it's the Ocean Idol show. I imagine it's similar to American Idol. Here's your teen club. Beside that is your Showtime Theater where they have the shows at night, or they'll have it in the plaza here. This theater itself is all enclosed. It's almost identical to a movie theater, same type of seating. And here's where they have most of the shows when the weather is good. And across there, that little small place in front, right in front of me, is where they have ice cream. But again, it doesn't open until like 5. That doesn't make sense. People want ice cream earlier than that. And behind that, you have your buffet. It is huge in there. Because basically, you have 600 rooms in the Alfaro side and about 300 rooms in the Albeso side. So that's a lot of guests. They say right now it's about 84% filled. A lot of people have missed flights to get here because of all that's going on right now with the airlines. So yeah, this is where they had the show. It was packed. So once you pass these arches on either side here, then you get into the accommodations. So all this up here is just services. You see the where we just came from, right in the lobby. Oh, over here is the sports bar. I'm from Canada, so Canada was playing last night. Got to see them win. Only small problem was that for some reason their feed down here, it kept on freezing. So at one point we looked at the score and it jumped from 2 to 3 and they're like, what? We didn't see the goal or nothing. problem with island life, hey? Dominican. And down here around the corner is your disco. I haven't checked that out. That doesn't open till like 10:30, 11 o'clock at night. It goes to like 1 or 2. So these are the accommodations. So all this here is Alfaro, and to the left over here is Albeso, which I'll go show you as well, and show you the room. Since we came so late, we'll be leaving late. Our flight doesn't leave till like almost 11:30, so we have to be at our room by 12, but apparently because we have the privilege bracelet, we're supposed to be able to keep our rooms till we need it. We'll find out. That'll be an interesting. They have, I think, three pools along here. And every time you see the yellow roof there, that's a swim-up bar. So every pool has its own swim-up bar. So this would be the family side. And they have swim-up rooms as well. No, maybe not. No, I'm sorry, I stand corrected. They have beds out front of them, but I don't see any water. Just on the vessel side. I can't see a thing through this, it's so bright. I'm hoping I'm not blurred or anything. Massive, massive place. Lots of people, but doesn't really feel that full. Like it doesn't feel overwhelming. I'm gonna show you shouldn't do this, but the beds here are not the greatest. They look kind of beat up and ratty looking. I'm gonna show you some of these. The mattress is not, and it's sitting on this wooden platform that's kind of looks like it's decaying from all the salt water. So, anyways, there's the lighthouse straight ahead. That's on the beach. That's the name, El Faro, meaning the lighthouse. It has a restaurant in it as well. You can go up to the very top and look out. I'm gonna stop the video at this point and until I get further along. So it takes about, roughly about 10 minutes to walk from the lobby to the beach. If you are looking for a resort, oh yeah, these are the, they can get a ride, catch a ride, just wave to them and they'll stop and pick you up. If you don't feel like walking that 10 minutes. Oh, if you don't like, if you're a beach person, I would say this is definitely not the resort to come to. There's the, there's tons of rocks in the water, tons of seaweed, like that's, yeah, that just happened, but they were breaking it one day and looked, they just kind of gave up on it because it was so bad. But the rocks everywhere, it's not a pleasant beach. Nobody, you ever see, don't see too many people on the beach. This is the Lazy River. I haven't tried it yet. It looks kind of fun. The water just slowly moves. Water park over there, big hit for the kids. Place to grab a snack up here, like hamburgers, hot dogs, tortilla chips. So they do supply inner tubes. There's probably, I'd say about 20 inner tubes. They have different sizes and shapes, so you don't have to worry. There seems to be always some available. They kind of congregate in one little area. They get all bunched up. I'm trying to look where they are now. Cool little water cannons. There's one there. A couple of heads there empty as well. Sorry about the wind, but I'm loving it right now because it seems very hot. And it's only like probably 11 o'clock right now. The bar is, most of the bars open 10 o'clock until 6. There's still some chairs available. This side it usually fills up fast, but I have a feeling a lot of people have slept in today. We've got a bar over here. It's a nice touch, they're playing the Spanish Latin music there, I love that. I'm not a fan of listening to American music. When you're in another country, you want to listen to their music. And they have this attempt at a putting green. I think they need to change it to carpet because the grass is just not working for it. I have never seen anybody play it yet. They just installed that about a year ago, I think. But not very popular. So this is one of the other privileged areas. There's a restaurant for the family in this side, and the El Beso is over there. We have breakfast there every morning. It's basically just buffet style, serve yourself. And over here is another restaurant. Show you the view from up there. So this will give you a better feel of what it looks like. This is El Faro, and right over here is El Beso. Now there's a resort off in the distance, the Royalton. That's about a 30-minute walk to that one, and you can see the seaweed down there. They're working at it. They're trying, but it seems like pretty useless. Might as well give up, I'd say. And if you walk that way, you'd have to walk probably about an hour to the next resort. It's all just... Sorry about the wind. There's another bar down there. And this room here, these two buildings here are both building 14. So if you wanted one right on the beach, those would be what you'd ask for, building 14. They don't have any kind of water activities here like kayaks, canoes, and paddle boats, stuff like that. So I can see rocks out there. I don't think they want to be hitting those rocks. You should do your photo op. Oh, another thing I forgot to mention, they do have people walking around the whole resort. Hola. They're wearing white, and they are with the timeshare. They'll approach you, start out a nice conversation, how are you doing, and stuff like that, and then they'll ease their way into the timeshare. It gets a little bit annoying, but if you just say no gracias and move on. They fooled me one time. He came up and he was pretending he was security and he wanted to see my bracelet and then he wanted to know who I was traveling with. And he gets into the conversation and I go, oh, you got me, you got me. There's the other side of the El Beso privilege lounge. By privilege, I mean like just anybody from El Beso can go. Anybody on this, we're heading over to El Beso now. And they have their own section for on the beach as well, but you can see there's not too many there now. So basically, this street here, it goes all the way down to the lobby. It divides the El Faro side from the El Beso. El Beso, I think I'm saying it wrong. I say Beso. It says adult only. That doesn't mean anything. The kids come over. It's sad. You talk to somebody and it's like a Dominican minute. We'll do that in a Dominican minute, it seems like. They're very, take their time with stuff. So this is where I am staying. We are staying, I mean. This is, there's two pools at the El Beso. One is the quiet pool, which is this one. They still play music at the bar, but it's kind of low-keyed. It's perfect for us. And the other one's a loud pool where they have all the pool games and the foam party. They had the foam party yesterday. The music really cranked. They like it loud. And you can probably hear from over here as well. They're giving away these drinks always in the morning. So I think it's trying to get you going. These are the swim-up rooms. People have said the water in is very cold, though. It's hard to get used to. The pool, it's a little bit cool when you get in, but you get used to it really fast. And as you can see, there's still spots available. The popular ones are these ones on the ends over here with the like the straw come over top of you, and it's like that bed lying down. So there you go. There's still one available there, I see, as well. It's like, or two, actually. Feels good to get in the shade. It is hot. I can't imagine when it gets up to 1 o'clock how hot it's going to be here. We got a little chess set here that we're playing. Great good activity. There's not too many washroom facilities either. There's one that when I first told about the road dividing. There's one up that way, almost on the beach. And then there's one, is this the snack bar? Yes. There's one single one on the other side of this greenhouse. And that's it. Nobody's ever in it. What does that say? Yeah. Yeah, same idea here. They have like hot dogs and hamburgers and salsa chips. They're not open yet. Probably not till 11. They're getting ready to open. They still got everything covered over.
Morning.
Morning. And their orange juice, well, it's not quite orange juice. I don't think they have oranges in Dominican. So it's almost like a weak orange flavored pop, if I could try to describe it, which is a shame. I love my orange juice in the morning. And this is the activity pool. The volleyball net, as well as basketball nets there. And I'll go up and show you the room now. Hopefully the maid has been. She was next door when I got the camera, so she'll probably have made our room by now, I'm thinking. And I'll show you the other room. All right, we're in 12305, which means building 12, third floor. Here's the bathroom. You have a rain head. Actually, there's two in here. There's one on the other side in there, too. And they supply you with the different stuff. Two sinks, hair dryer they supply you with, water closet or toilet, whatever you call it. And over here, you have your safe, an umbrella, a couple of coffee station. Below it, you have your mini fridge with peanuts, water. The wine is we brought back from one of the restaurants. Maybe a beer, pop, and even some hard liquor. And there's a yogurt in there that was an apple juice. I think that's apple juice. Yes, it is. And here you have your steamer for getting wrinkles out. And here's your living area. The plugs all work. You don't have to buy any special adapters. Just plug right in. They actually even have the USB port here and the clock, two of them. So there's two there, and also the plug. You got some reading lights. You want to stay up late. Nice ceiling fan. Comes in handy because you see the door is wide open. We are not fans of air conditioning. Believe it or not, we love the heat. So a lot of times we'll just pull the drapes across and leave that wide open, and it is quiet enough that You can hear the ocean off in the distance. Some lighthouse work, I guess, because this is El Faro, which means the lighthouse. And this is our view. Got a little swinging chair there. Those who like to swing. And a little seating area here. And we got lucky because they're working. There's maintenance going on in the room on either side of us, so we don't have neighbors on either side of us. The rooms are under repair. And this is our view. At the quiet pool. This is the quiet pool. And there's a place, I might have forgot to mention, that's where you get your towels over there. They supply two in the room when you first get here. And oh yeah, we noticed that there was no robes in the room, so because we are privileged, we had to, that's something we had to call and ask for, and they delivered a couple of robes as well. So if you didn't get any and you're in privilege, just tell your butler and they'll get you a couple. And that's all. Oh yeah, the channels. There's maybe Fox, CNN, a lot of Spanish channels, a couple of movie channels. But we don't really watch the TV at all. Just had to turn it on and see what was on it. Bye for now.